Along with you all, my heart sank yesterday at the news that the lockdown would continue at least for another week. Again, we're left waiting until we can gather again. The situation puts great uncertainty on our businesses and on people's livelihoods. Our schools begin term three next week without the benefit of being at school. All of us are not sure just how this new eruption of the virus will play out and what might be needed to bring it into containment again. And all of this is occurring just when we thought that we were on top of it all. How we are beginning to miss you all. The church has been so empty and the office quiet. We're really starting to feel the effect of not being able to gather. When I go into the church, I look around though, and in my mind, I picture where different people sit, and I spend a moment or two praying for the ones who come into my mind and heart. So in this way, I do keep mindful of you and united with you through though we cannot see one another. Father Joey would also like to share a few thoughts with you.
Hi everyone, I'm sure you miss us as we miss all of you, especially during the weekends. And of course, all of us miss being with God in the church, especially in our Eucharistic celebration. Though our church is not open, let us not cease to pray to Him wherever we are. It is really frustrating that we have gone back to the lockdown. But Pope Francis says that we can make the pandemic as a time for our conversion. With the lockdown, it gives us a time to stop. And this stoppage causes tension within us that reveals what is in our hearts, what is important to us. This revelation in turn helps us to ponder what needs to be changed, the idols that we have been serving, the ideologies that we have tried to live by, and the relationships that we have neglected. And as we put on our mask, we are also reminded of the mask that we have put on to cover our shame and our vulnerabilities in order to be accepted by other people. One of the important questions that we could ask ourselves in this lockdown is, where am I in my relationship with God? Let's ask Our Lady then to wrap her mantle of protection on us for our safety and the safety of all our loved ones. God bless.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters in Christ. Perhaps just like you, I really felt frustrated after finding out today that we will be on another week of lockdown. Every time I entered the church to pray, I really felt sad to see empty pews. However, in my prayer, I really felt deep within me that I am not alone, because I know every time I pray, you are also praying with me wherever you may be. Our church may be closed at this time, but the church remains opened because we are the church. The good news is Jesus Christ, who unites us, is greater than the COVID-19 which separates us. I look forward to seeing you all again in person. You are greatly missed. Our Lady of Dolores, pray for us.
Hopefully next week we might have a message from Deacon Kevin as well. As we wait, let's continue to act with responsibility to limit our movement, so as not to provide the opportunity for the virus to be further transmitted. Let us use the time for a little extra prayer and reading. Let us join in the Eucharist with spiritual communion in one of the many ways open to us, especially with Mass for You at Home that can be found on YouTube each week. These Masses are beautifully presented and they have an intimacy about them, so I do recommend them to you. Also, on this Sunday morning at 9 a.m, we have the opportunity to join a parish online liturgy of the word, which Angela Haig facilitates. The details of this will be in the bulletin. Though we can't meet in person, A number of our parish groups do continue to connect with one another through online means. Our parish pastoral and missionary council will do this next Wednesday. To keep ourselves connected in a responsible way during this time is so important. We will continue to keep everyone updated. In the meantime, be assured we are thinking of you, holding our community before the Lord.